It is your girl, my aunt Nicole, coming back at you with another video. So let's get into it. Okay, so as you can see in the title, we are going to be talking about relationships and spirituality. And when I'm talking about relationships, I mean all aspects of relationships, when friendships, family relationships, romantic relationships. We're going to be getting into it today. Don't forget to check out all of my other videos on this channel. I know you guys are going to enjoy them. And if you are new here, welcome, welcome, welcome. We are so happy to have you all here. Okay, so the first thing I do want to say is going back to Law of Attraction, which was one of my first videos, so go ahead and check that out with Law of Attraction. If you've been here with me since day one, you already know what the whole Law of Attraction means. So with Law of Attraction, you attract what you are and who you are. And with a lot of relationships that we're in today, we have to realize that we have attracted them to us, and we have to accept the consequences that comes with these relationships that we have brought to ourselves. So with that being said, when you're on your spiritual walk, it's going to be people that come into your life that is going to give you some type of life lesson. They're there to guide you into the next level of consciousness, or they're there to help you get over something. Like, they might just be there for like a short period of time, just there, you know, for certain reasons. It's a plethora of reasons of why a person is in your life. The universe only knows, and you will only know really after it all happens. So let's talk about romantic relationships really quick, and then we're gonna go into the other ones. I'm not gonna make this a really long video. I feel like everyone kind of talks about relationships, so I don't wanna like bore you guys too much about it. I just want to just tell you about the spirituality and, you know, just relationships in general. So, romantic relationships. So, you're wondering why you're dating, like, this asshole, or he's just totally mean, or, you know, he's a cheater. You know, he's not everything you want and need, but you're still sticking around, you know. And this goes both ways for male and female. We stay in these relationships hoping and praying for potential, and looking at the guy or the woman and just like, oh, well, they seem nice and their potential is great and all that good stuff. You have to know that you are attracting this person. Well, you have attracted this person. And if they're an ass, or if they're a jerk, or they're a liar, 9 times out of 10, you're an ass, you're a jerk, and you're a liar, deep down inside. And it's a cause for you to look in the mirror and to check yourself and really look deep inside and just ask yourself, who am I? Am I this mean person? Can I be a liar? Am I an asshole? Like, really look at yourself, because you attract what you are. And if all this crap, negativity, relationships, BS relationships is coming into your life, then that means you have not cleared out all the negativity in your life. You must have some type of deep wounds that needs to be unblocked. You might have some chakras that might be out of whack. I'll talk more about chakras later. And it might be some things that might be out of whack within. So you might have to go within, take a good look at yourself in the mirror, and ask yourself, what is going on with you? What do you need to heal? What do you need to fix? We all are here to heal ourselves. We are all here to remember who we are deep down inside. And a lot of our human selves, outside selves, take over our real self, our inner self, the Most High. So you have to be mindful of the people that you pick. And really, you're subconsciously picking these people, not even really noticing that they are you. And so when you're on this spiritual walk, you get to learn more about yourself. You are starting to slowly heal yourself. And then if you noticed, your relationship starts maybe going down a little bit, and it's like, I'm such in a great place in my life, you know, I'm happy and I finally found myself, you know, things of that nature, but why can't my relationships be good? And it's because when you're elevating in the spirit world or spirituality, the person that you was once before is gone. It's not you anymore. So that man or that woman that you're with, they was the person that you was before, so they can't come with you because you have elevated into a better self. You are becoming a better self. So the ones who hold that older self energy, they have to go, because if they dwell with you, if they stay with you, you might end up going back to what you were trying to get away from. So with that being said, we go into friendships. Older friendships. We all grow up with that one friend or friends. And then we grow out of friendships. And you grow out of your friendships because one or the other person has grown up. Spiritually, if you really think about it, they have grown up spiritually. They are a totally different person, and they might have to let you go because they need to better themselves and their life. And you may still be at the place that they were once before, and they have to leave because, you know, you're that friend, that negative friend, to be honest, not even trying to, you know, sound crazy or anything, but I'm just being real. You might have been that negative friend, or they might have been that negative friend who is always complaining and nagging and who doesn't really understand, you know, the spirit world and spirituality in general. And as you grow, you have to let them go. And it's the same thing with family members. We are with our family members for our whole entire lives. We start to act like them, and some of their habits may not be the most positive, and so you inherit those ways. But then when you're on your spiritual walk, you're starting to let those ways go, and in turn you may have to let some family members go, especially the ones who act out in that way all the time or majority of the time. So you have to take control of your own life. And if you have to let some people go just to keep yourself sane and to make sure yourself is elevated, then you may have to let some people go. And it's not saying that, hey, I can't come back, we can't be friends again. It's just saying, let me get myself together, my mind, my soul. Let me get myself together first, and I'll come right back to you. Because when you really, really grow to like your full potential, which we only really won't get to our full potential until we actually pass away, let's be real. But when you're to a point where you can accept the negativity and let it go when it doesn't bother you, things of that nature, then you could probably come back to a family member or a friend, you know, and maybe just help them out. It's just right now, I have to help myself out. And then when I'm good and I'm good to go and life is the way it's supposed to be, I'll come back and I'll come back to help you, you know? And if they don't want to be helped, then they probably shouldn't have been in your life. And that's just what it is. So that's my intake on spirituality and relationships. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope it wasn't too long because I wasn't trying to make it too long. But I feel like a lot of people may want to know why some of their relationships are not working. It's because you're leveling up, honey. It's because even if you don't know you're on a spiritual walk, you're on a spiritual walk. And it's time to let these people go so you can love yourself more and you can take care of yourself. And when you're done, you can go back and you can help them out. And if a person is not there to help you grow, then you really don't want them in your life. And that's just what it is. So I'm going to leave you guys with that. If you have any questions, if you have any comments, please comment below. Please give me a like if you really like this video. I'm trying to get to my 1,000 subscribers, so don't forget to subscribe if you are new here. And I love you guys. Shay, amen, amen.